Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at another knife from Bucher Plus, as you can see by the box on the table. And today it is about a pretty iconic Bucher Plus design with a little new twist on it, so a new iteration of one of the first designs that the Bucher Plus came out with, and it is of course the Bucher Plus Excalibur One, a really nice front flipper design they made in collaboration with Fred Berger and Mike Skellern, and that is also the reason why it is called Excalibur and why it is written in that particular way. So really nice design, and they did a few changes here on this new version that we're going to talk about later on in the video. And now let's start with the specs as always. So we have an overall length here on this knife of 8 inches or 20.4 centimeters. That gives us a blade length here on the Excalibur One of 3.5 inches or 8.9 centimeters. The steel on this version is VG10. On the previous versions, it was 440C. We also have a blade thickness here of 2.8 millimeters, so slightly under 3 millimeters, but still plenty strong. And you have a handle length of 4.5 inches or 11.5 centimeters. So you have a really nice, good sized knife with a very interesting and useful blade shape here. Really nice in hand. Enough room here for even larger hands than mine. So really nice overall design here right off the bat. Now let's take a look at the weight of this knife. And this is really an area where this knife excels. And it weighs 91 grams or 3.2 ounces, which is really a very nice weight for the size of this knife, and they achieved that by the use of materials on this design. So they used for the main part of the handle just G10 slabs on both sides. They have a Cytel or G10 backspacer here, the red liner, and then they have a titanium liner for the liner lock, which they have anodized in this bronze color here on this VG10 version. On the regular Excalibur ones, it was anodized blue, the same color as the clip is anodized here. So they used really lightweight materials, and that's how they could keep the weight so nice and reasonable for the good size of the knife. You have here a 3.5 inch long blade, and still a very lightweight knife, and it feels really even lighter in hand. Now let's take a closer look at the 3.5 inch long VG10 steel blade of the Bucher Plus Excalibur One. And you can see you have a very nice and interesting blade shape. I would call that a spear point blade shape with a good amount of belly. You have a slight hollow grind from nearly all the way up, just a small flat portion here at the top. And of course, you have your Bucher Plus logo and a very gorgeous satin finish with only horizontal striations. Very well done. It's one of the nicest satin finishes that I have seen in a while. Other than that, you have your serial number. Mine is number 462. On the top, you have a very good amount of jimping, pretty fine jimping, which also doubles as your front flipper deployment option. On the other side of the blade, you have the marking of one of the designers, Mike Skellern, and the marking that it is indeed VG10 steel. VG10 steel is a very well-known steel. It was and is used in a lot of different Spyderco knives, and is quite a proven steel. It's a premium Japanese cutlery steel with good edge retention, very good corrosion resistance, and also a fine grain structure, so you can get a really nice razor's edge on a VG10 blade. So a very nice steel choice here by Bucher Plus on the Excalibur One, and they moved to the VG10 on a lot of their newer models, so they seem to move away from the 440C that they have used previously, and I like that change quite a bit. So overall, a really nice blade shape here, very interesting, very useful with a lot of belly. Comes also very sharp out of the box, and just a really nice home run blade. Really good looking here on the Excalibur One. Now let's take a closer look at the handle design and construction. And you can see you have a handle constructed mostly of this really gorgeously finished G10. So it is smooth finish. You don't have a lot of traction from this G10, but it just looks very gorgeous. It is not polished, so you have a little bit of traction, but not much. Other than that, you have a nice decorative pivot screw, which is not adjustable with any kind of standard Torx bit or something like that. But what's nice about the Bucher Plus knives here is that you actually get the spanner tool you need for the pivot with every knife you order. So that is a really nice thing that they do here from Booker Plus. So because of that, I have absolutely no problem with the proprietary pivot hardware, and it just looks really nice. Other than that, the handle of the knife is put together by some small Torx screws, as you can see here, three of them. One thing I noticed here is that the last screw here in the back is much further into the handle, so a little bit of a miss here. It would be nicer if it was just flush with the handle, like the other two screws. A little flaw in my opinion, but not a big deal. Other than that, of course, you have your titanium liner here for your liner lock. Here you also can take a look at the lockup. And there is another little miss here on this knife, is that the whole liner should be anodized in a gold or bronze color. But you can see here on this side of the liner, it is nearly not anodized at all. So it's just a standard silver color. And then it fades into the bronze color here on the bottom part of the titanium liner. And then on the back, it is nicely bronze colored. So they had a little bit of a challenge here on the anodizing of this liner, so that could be improved certainly. Here you can see also the stop pin, which is a really nice massive stop pin. And of course the red liner here in the back as well, which adds a little bit of color and looks quite nice. Then you have a backspacer, so it's not a flow-through construction, only a little small part here at the front. So a little bit harder to clean out. But overall, the handle construction is very well done in my opinion. Just some minor things there. You also have a titanium pocket clip here, anodized blue. This anodization is done very well and evenly. And the pocket clip comes installed tip down, can be switched to tip up carry here as well. One other little thing that I don't like as much is a thing that I noted on a lot of knives, is that these screws are just screwed through and there is no screw head on this side, just these little holes, which just look a little bit cheap in my opinion. So overall, a really nice handle construction with some minor aesthetic flaws, but in hand this knife feels very nice in a hammer grip, really absolutely no hot spots. Really nice in hand in a grip like this as well. Also, a reverse grip is possible and there is absolutely no hotspot. It really melts in your hand and there are absolutely no flaws on the fit and finish. Otherwise, you can see here everything is flush and nicely fitted. So overall, a really nice handle design. The clip could be a little bit better. It's not a deep carry, but I really like that it is titanium and anodized blue. It really looks very handsome. And the pocket clip screws are Phillips head, which is a little bit weird, and this screw right here is a little bit stripped out, as you can see, so that is also a little bit of a slight problem here on the quality control. But other than that, and overall, I'm pretty pleased with the handle. Really cool and ergonomic design here on the Excalibur One. Now let's take a look at action and deployment of this knife, and this is a point where this knife really excels. So you can see you can flick it open with your thumb like this because it's a front flipper design. That means that you open it with this little lip here at the top, which is jimped. So you just catch that with your thumb and then you can open it slowly and controlled like this, or just let fly it open like that. You can also flick it with your index finger if you hold it the right way. In front of the camera it's really hard to do, but it goes like this. So really nice opening methods, but of course you can also just open it like that as well. So really nice opening mechanism, and you also saw how smooth this knife is actually. So if I disengage the lock bar, it falls shut very nicely, and it is not on bearings. These are Teflon or plastic washers. If you can take a look here in the pivot area, maybe you can see in there. They are white plastic washers, nothing fancy in the pivot, but really smooth, and it came that way out of the box. I didn't do anything, didn't use oil or any kind of grease, just very smooth out of the box. You can also take a look at the centering here, which is nearly perfect, slightly to the right I would say, but very well done here on centering as well. You saw the lockup earlier. And we're gonna take a look here. No side-to-side play, no up and down, so really nice lockup here on this knife. And that coupled with that insanely smooth action, I was really impressed with that. I didn't expect this knife to be that smooth, considering that it's just on some plastic washers. So overall, really nice deployment, rock solid lockup, and near perfect centering. So they really did a pretty good job here on the action of the Excalibur One. And I quite like this front flipper mechanism. It's a nice, pretty concealed opening method. You don't have a hole in the blade or a thumb stud sticking up or a flipper here on the backside of your handle. Just a nice clean design, but you can still open it very fast, and it's still quite a fun knife to play with. So I'm quite a fan here of the front flipper design of the Excalibur One. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of the Excalibur One. I now had this knife for 2.5 to 3 months in my EDC rotation. It came hair shaving sharp out of the box from Bucher Plus. And now let's see how sharp it is now. So with this hollow grind, this knife makes a really, really nice cutter. Very, very sharp still. And with the VG10 steel, you can see it just goes through this paper like through butter. They did such a nice job here on the grinding and after the EDC use, which is opening packages, letters, cutting straps, cutting cardboard. It still is very, very sharp. Very impressed with the VG10 they use here and how they heat treat and grind it. They really know what they're doing. Very impressed with the sharpness here on the Excalibur One. Very well done. Now let's come to the size comparisons I like to do. And the first comparison I have for you is pretty much the only knife that can compete with the weight and the size here with the Excalibur One by Bucher Plus. And it is the SAWQ Aegis, a really nice lightweight tactical folder, which has AUS-8 steel and a Zytel style handle and the Arc Lock. Really, really nice, very sharp and pointy blade here from SAWQ. And you can see size-wise, these two are very, very similar overall. Also weight-wise, I think the Aegis is about 3 grams lighter than the Excalibur here at the bottom, but very, very comparable. Also can take a look at the thickness, if I can stand them up. Also very comparable in the thickness, but the clip is much more deep carry here on the SAWQ. Of course, they're famous for that, but I really also like the blue colorization here on the titanium clip on the Excalibur One. The next comparison I have for you is more of a comparison in the overall straight design of the knife. It's a non-locking knife, and it's of course the Manly Comrade with the grooved G10 handles and the D2 steel blade. Really nice knife out of Bulgaria here, and you can see some kind of similarity in the overall design. This nice straight look with nothing standing off from the blade. Also extremely, extremely sharp here, the Manly Comrade. Really, really nice blades, both of them. And the last comparison I have for you is going to be a more traditional knife, much, much heavier, but also has this straight, no bells and whistles overall design, in my opinion. Here, the RLT from Claude Dasaume. You can see size-wise, very, very close overall. Really, really nice traditional knife with this very gorgeous horn handles. You got the 14C28 end steel here, and actually ball bearings in the pivot, which is really a very nice addition for such a nice traditional knife. But of course, it also has no lock, and you can see size-wise, very, very similar, but much, much heavier here than the Excalibur One, which just offers so much blade for its weight. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about this knife. So if you want to get yourself your own Excalibur One with the VG10 steel, you are going to pay around $90 to $100 depending on where you get it. You're going to find a link to my recommended retailers, White Mountain Knives, in the description below. He has it for around $85 if I'm not mistaken. So really good price here on the Bucher Excalibur One with the upgraded steel and the bronze colored liners. And for that price, I think with the VG10 steel, this is a pretty nice buy because you get so much blade and so much usable knife for such a lightweight package. I really like the overall design of this knife, very, very ergonomic, and the action of this knife is just unbelievable. Extremely, extremely smooth, as you have seen throughout the review. and dead running on washers is really, really an exceptional achievement. Rock solid lockup and just a really gorgeous blade shape. Very, very nice set and finish on the blade as well. And very, very sharp out of the box. And I think the front flipper mechanism is just so much fun to play with. And I really like that it is something different and something very clean. I really appreciate that they did a new version with the upgraded seal from the 440C to the VG10, which I think is quite a nice step up in steel quality. But if you don't like this particular version with the G10 handles, there are a couple of other versions you can get this knife with different wood scales. There is an olive wood version available. There are also frame lock versions available, one with a full titanium frame lock and also a titanium handle scale, and there is a carbon fiber handle scaled version with a titanium frame lock as well. But these versions with the frame lock are considerably thinner than this knife, so they are not going to be as hand feeling and as nice in hand as the G10 or wood versions will be. And there is also a smaller version available called the Excalibur 2, which in my opinion in most versions has a nail nick and is not deployable with your front flipper mechanism, but I'm not 100% sure on that. So a lot of versions to choose from. I really like the larger version here because it is very lightweight and still has a really nice 3.5-inch long VG10 blade. Overall, I would recommend this knife. I'm very happy with mine. I think it's money well spent for such a nice lightweight knife with good steel. So that was my review on the Böker Plus Excalibur 1 with the upgraded version with the bronze colored titanium liner lock and the VG10 steel. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions about anything I talked about in the video, please leave it in the comments below. I will try to answer you there. And if you want to see more of these knife gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.